This still hasn't rotted off yet.
Yeah, you've, yeah. You gotta be careful with Creepy Charlie, because he's been around.
Yeah, I can tell.
He's got diseases. All the diseases that you could be pleasing for. All the diseases you could ever want. They got red diseases, black diseases. They got the rotten gingivitis diseases. They got the make your feet stink diseases. They got the rotten pieces of meat diseases. They got the rotten meat feet diseases. Make your feet rot like meat.
They even got the new Russian venereal disease. It's called Ratchakakov.
Mm. And then they got, like, you know, they've got, like, AIDS sickles and, you know, they're like popsicles that give you AIDS.
Howdy there, folks. My name's Creepy Charlie. Welcome to another episode of the Abbey of the Lemur. We got lots of fun for you tonight, and we just want you to hang tight and enjoy. We gonna be serving you up a bunch of slop and entertainment you won't ever forget. Thank you. Hold on to your britches.
Hi, kids. This is your Aunt Gertrude with more shitty news from Moscow.
Well, so, have the Giants won over there?
The Giants haven't done crap, but the Red Sox are kicking ass.
Okay, then, what about the butterfly monsters?
The butterfly monsters?
Yeah.
Well, they were eaten by porpoises.
What kind of porpoise?
Purple porpoises.
With purpose?
We fought the purple porpoises on purpose.
Where the porcupine was eating a pork pie? I killed lots of people. I mean, no, I didn't.
Well, he's back now just to spite your ass.
Well, you know, my ass is, not the cause of problems here. I think it is...
Well, your ass is 14 karat. We all like your ass. It's been celebrated in legend and song, but,
Well, yeah, ancient Viking runes tell stories of my ass. Like, if we'd stopped to translate that rune... Yeah, it would have just said...
That's what the heathen runes are all about.
Jacob's ass is pure gold.
And it's friends with Mr. Dingus.
That is true.
Where is Mr. Dingus?
Where is Mr. Dingus?
Up your ass?
Not to my knowledge. I think I know.
Mr. Dingus. Mr. Dingus has gone.
Mr. Dingus.
But,
Oh, yeah.
But we all need more dingi in our life.
True. What about dingoes?
Dingoes aren't as much fun as a dingus.
True enough, and they're a lot harder to get up your ass.
Dingoes present the same problem as jackals and hyena when attempting rectal insertion.
Yeah, they're kind of pointy at like five of their six ends.
And they quarrel.
That's true. Quarreling!
They become surly when introduced into one's anal cavities.
Yeah, quarreling has ruined many a supreme assness.
Well,
or something.
So kids, remember, when you're out there at home trying to insert a live dingo up your ass, well, just don't.
Well, even, like, sometimes?
On the high holy days.
Okay. With lube?
With lube, and I have several kinds I could recommend, mayonnaise being one.
Yeah, because, then...
Dingoes go better with mayonnaise.
Well, then after you're done, you can make it in your ass into a sandwich.
Yeah, ass sandwich.
What sort of salad goes best with an ass sandwich?
KY salad with an ass sandwich.
KY salad?
KY salad, yeah, it's really good.
Is that like the dressing on it?
Yeah, that's the dressing. You can put KY on like Caesar or just about any kind of salad.
I see. Well, in closing, I think that what we have learned today is that... Well, no, I think what I've learned today is you shouldn't drink mercury. Through a straw.
Or calamine lotion.
Well, a little bit.
Well, hi there, folks. It's me, Creepy Charlie, again. And as you can tell, I won the old lotto, and I get to host the Abbey of the Lemur this week. Well, you can probably tell by looking at me and all these fine bees that I just done Mardi Gras just recently. And, well... I went all the way down to the Gulf because the other lemurs are pretty much strapped for cash. And I just want to tell you that the cleanup efforts are going fine down there. And we got lots of new folks building, lots of new property, bringing in lots of new stuff. Pretty soon them poor folks are never gonna have to come back and darken those shores again. That's right. It's gonna be Fun City. Just like here in Fayetteville, we gonna be running out all them poor folks. Everything's gonna be fine. We're gonna be bringing in those yuppies and it's all gonna be good. Well, let me show you more of the fun. We got more fun happening here on Abbey the Lemur this week. Now, check out this little tidbit.
can't forget about old Johnny Johnny McHanson.
Yeah. Is it Johnny McHanson? Johnny Joe McHanson?
Johnny Joe McHanson or something like that.
Liz knows this character better than either one of us.
Yeah, he does. She does. And we're all out of work and John's gotten a job recently working for RGIS.
Yeah.
But I'm still looking for work, so if anybody's out there wanting to hire a lemur.
So, I mean, some of you have fared as far as gainful employment better than others.
Well, there's Johnny Joe.
Yeah, Joe McHanson.
Well, you see, Johnny's a real quiet boy, so he doesn't talk.
You got to watch out for the quiet.
He doesn't talk to many people, but I know him pretty well because he's a good friend of mine. He told me about all this. He's out of town, pretty much permanently, but. I've been keeping tabs on him, so I know what happened. And immediately when he got out of this, he was looking for work. The first thing logically was to go to NASA, and so it's 1984. It's 1984. We're finally going to be able to live on the moon, and so Johnny applied to try to be one of the space rangers that could, check out the moon for us and do a lot of landscaping and things like that. And, anyway, he wasn't able to actually pass enough of the test to actually go, but because of his background in janitorial work, he was able to be a latrine cleaner on the ship. And, they went up there and, he killed time in between by playing his guitar because, he didn't tell many people, but he actually liked to play music a lot in between. And so he gets up, the Moon Rangers, they get up to the moon and they go out to the jungles of the moon, right? And they're going through the moon jungle and then they get attacked by fell beasts, right? And they don't know what to do because these fell beasts are attacking them. And, their moon beams, that they brought with them had no effect. Their space rays were just totally ineffective. But then some Moonotians come and help them and, spirit them away to the city of Moonotia. And there they met their leader, Beowulf. It makes total sense,
Beowulf,
of course.
Jones?
No, just Beowulf. The historical Beowulf.
Beowulf Smith.
It's probably his last name. I don't know, but anyway, it makes total sense. Earth's greatest hero, Beowulf, is the leader of the moon. And so anyway, he's ruling Moonotia, and he tells them that the fell beasts were actually demons sent by the devil himself, because he's trying to steal ancient moon technology and use it to subjugate the human race. And so anyway...
I'm sorry.
Number as it appeared to him, with round black sunglasses and perm hair. So then, proving himself worthy, he lifted the axe upon high, and there was thunder and lightning and banshees squealing
and a mouse farting.
Then he had to cross the river Styx, and he had to go to Satan Castle. And within the depths of Satan Castle,
Mr. Roboto,
he and the devil had this monumental guitar duel. It was like Deliverance, but heavy metal. And
then
squeal like Eddie Van Halen's guitar.
Yeah, squeal like a pig, baby. But anyway, he liberated the moon from the devil, and right now I think he's in a, I think he's washing dishes, and he's playing in like a Foreigner cover band.
Most tragic.
Or a Genesis cover band. I hope it's a Foreigner.
Either way.
Either way, it's still kind of tragic.
I mean,
it'd be better if it was a Foreigner.
But yeah, I don't know. It'd be alright if it was his Genesis if they were playing the old Peter Gabriel stuff. But you know,
yeah, that's true.
Have a cab!
See my nipples? At least one of them.
He only has one nipple, folks.
Well, he can't
afford it.
Yeah,
he has two nipples, but he can only show you one nipple at a time.
All this time, but I've been taking pity on you because you got one goddamn nipple, and now it turns out you got two, you two-nipple non-freak. What the hell are you trying to pull? Get all this, like, government assistance because you ain't got two nipples? Man, this is some bullshit.
I don't want to pay taxes for that.
Yeah, I don't want to pay taxes for your non-existent, non-existent nipple.
I never claimed to have one nipple. I've always claimed to have two nipples.
That's beside the point.
But one of those nipples has Down syndrome.
Yeah, you got a retarded nipple.
That's this one right here. This one's name is
AKA Clem. Yeah, I'm knocking shit over bad. Especially the shit that was on fire. Well, if the furniture's orange and wavy, it probably means it's on fire.
Yeah. There's this black stuff coming up from off, but it definitely means it's on fire. Well, safety tip for you. Stop, drop, and roll. Nothing does much good if you're rolling in a lot of gasoline.
Yeah, well, it didn't do him much good on 9/11. Stop, drop, and roll 100 stories.
No, it didn't.
Only urinate professionally now.
I lost it with the two-headed dino, like a freaking two-headed turtle that I'm fucking right now in the asshole, in the asshole.
Oh, somebody go call Ann Hannah and Brian Maloney. They're so dumb they'll think this is pornography.
Well, I hope y'all enjoyed tonight's festivities. We've been having a good time, me and Lil Plush Godzilla here. And we've been enjoying tonight's episode of The Abbey of the Lemur. And it was a pleasure for them allowing us to host like this. We hope y'all tune in next time, you hear?
Sauce, lame-ass, weak, non-threatening, suburban white boy junk played by bands like Men Without Testicles. 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 Reach over here and fondle my balls. Reach over here and fondle my balls. in the basement jacking off his dog. Fist in the basement jacking off his dog. Pointless meandering zombie noise. Lunatic. Fist in the basement jacking off his dog. Lunatic. Pointless meandering zombie noise. Lunatic. Pointless meandering zombie noise. Pointless meandering zombie noise.
Fuck these new age techno dicks. Whatever happened to music with testicles? Testicles.
Testicles. And so what do you have to say to Fayetteville?
Ladies and gentlemen, a parting shot.
Okay, keeping up with a fine lemur tradition. Oh, look out, we're obscene or something.
Yeah.
Anyway, later.